So, you want to create a custom livery for your F122 My Team career. But every tutorial on YouTube tells you to use Photoshop, an expensive suite of image editing software aimed at professionals. Well, I'm here to tell you that you can create an awesome custom livery and import it into the game using nothing but free to download software. In this video, we're going to cover everything you'll need to create a high quality custom livery, from the software required, step-by-step process of generating the livery, and ending with how it will look in the game. So, without further ado, let's get started. Hi, I'm Roy Waller, a sim racer and commentator over at twitch.tv/RoyWaller. Tune in now to catch me playing F122 My Team with the livery I will be creating in this video. Link in the description below. Okay, so let's get started with the tutorial. And first things first, we're going to need to cover the software required. To create our texture files, we will require some image editing software. I will be using GIMP, but in theory, you can use anything as long as it allows you to export images as a .tiff. Secondly, we will need to compress these images into .dds files. This is where most other tutorials will require Photoshop. We, however, will be using a free tool called AMD Compressinator. Finally, we need to open up the package files of the game and slot in our creations. To do this, we will use the Ego ERP archiver created by Peter Tasev. He has provided this tool at a name your price, so if you think it's worth it, chuck him a couple of dollars. Links to all of these tools can be found in the description below, along with a link to a Google Drive folder with all of the GIMP projects I will be using in this tutorial. So I'd recommend pause the video right now, grab the software and the files, and then we will commence with the rest of the tutorial. First, we're going to need to create the textures for our livery. For this tutorial, I will be using the GIMP projects in the Google Drive link below, but feel free to create your own as we go along. You will notice there are actually four project files in the folder. This is because the liveries in F122 are actually made up of four components: the badge, the driver number, the halo sticker, and the livery texture itself. Let's start with the badge, as that's the simplest of the three. For this tutorial, I'm going to use my channel logo, but you can use any image you like, as long as you make sure it's on a square canvas. Once you finish with your design, we'll leave that open and move on to the driver number. This again is pretty simple, just a number in the middle of the canvas. However, there are two things to bear in mind. First, you should leave a margin around the number, as I have done in the example. This is just to make sure the number is aligned correctly on the car. Second, although you can, in theory, put anything you like in your driver number image, you will still be restricted to the numbers available in the game. So it's worth checking whether the number you want is available before you get started. Otherwise, the number that appears on your car will be different to what appears elsewhere in the game UI. Next, we'll take a look at the halo sticker. I've used this to do some cheeky self-promotion, as the halo will be on display for the majority of my stream. Please bear in mind this is a short and wide image, and the halo itself has some curves on the bottom edge, so you may need to experiment with the layout, as these could cut into your design. The final, and most complicated texture we need to create is the livery itself. For the purpose of this tutorial, we will mainly be concentrating on the technical process of creating the livery and won't be going into too much detail on how to design the livery. Now, once you've opened up the project, you'll see that the livery itself is actually made up of two parts. The first is the texture image, and that will paint the design you create onto the 3D model. The other is the material shader, and this will set the reflectiveness of each part of the paintwork. As you can see, the livery image looks nothing like an F1 car. This is because the texture will be wrapped around the car model in-game. Unfortunately, unlike Photoshop, GIMP is not able to display 3D models, so the best way I've found to match up parts of the texture to the panels on the car is to just paint on them and then check in-game. Now, in order to get our images into the correct format, we need to export them as TIFF files. To do that, we will go to File, and then Export As. Then in the bottom of the dialog box, we'll expand Select File Type, and scroll down to TIFF Image. In the Export Image as TIFF dialog box, we want to make sure Save Layers is deselected and Save Color Profile is selected. Once this is done, we can go ahead and do this for all four project files. For the livery project, we want to make sure we export the design and the material shaders as separate images. Now we've got all our images created, it's time to compress them, ready for packaging. Once all our images are exported, it's time to open AMD Compressinator. To make our lives simpler going forward, we're going to create a project file and save it alongside our exported images. This will save us time in the future if we decide we want to edit our liveries. Now we're in our new project, we want to import all the images we exported from GIMP. Once these are all loaded, we want to expand the selection below each of these images and double-click Add Destination Settings. Handily, the default settings are exactly what we're looking for. We want to compress our images as .dds files and use BC7 compression. Hit save and repeat this process for the three other files. Once they all have a destination setting added, we want to select all four images, right click, and select Compress Selected Images. Wait for this to complete, and we will have four DDS files ready to package up into our game files. Before we start playing with the game packages, it's worth pointing out that any of these changes could impact your ability to play the game online, especially when it comes to multiplayer. I would recommend creating backups of any ERP files we touch so you can replace them whenever you want to play online. But don't worry, if you skip this step, you can still revert this by using the repair option in either Steam or the EA app. Now we are going to insert our images into the game files using the Ego ERP archiver. As these packages are stored in program files, we need to run the archiver as administrator. To do this, we will need to right-click the executable and then click Run as Administrator. Now we have the application open, the first thing we're going to do is tell the application where our game is installed. To do this, we go to Settings, Game Directory, Set Directory. For Steam users, this will be in your Steam app's common directory. I have the game installed via the EA Games app, so my game is found in Program Files /EA Games. Now that's set, we'll start by adding our emblem to the game packages. To do this, we will first need to open the ERP package that contains one of the in-game custom emblems. From the root games directory, we need to go into the 2022 assets group directory, followed by UI packages, texture arrays, customization, CSTM badge large, and then finally emblem. Then we need to select which emblem we want to replace. For this tutorial, I'm going to pick the back-to-back emblem as it's the first in the list in-game. You can replace any other emblem that you have unlocked. Just bear in mind, whichever emblem you choose will no longer be available in-game. Once we've opened the package, in the texture tab, we'll select the emblem image. In this case, emblem-backtoback.tiff. We'll then replace this with our emblem image by going to textures and then import. Then we need to find the .dds we created for the emblem and click open. Now the emblem in the package has been replaced with our custom image, we need to save the ERP back into the game directory. Thankfully, the rest of the textures we need to replace are all found in the same ERP file. We can get there by returning to 2022 asset groups, F1 2022 vehicle package, and then teams. Here we want to open the file named common.fom.erp. First up, we'll replace the driver number. Scroll down to find the textures starting with FOM car driver. Then you'll need to find the one with the number you want to use. In my case, it's the number 13. Then, as we did with the emblem, we'll import our driver number DDS file. When it asks for the MIPMAPS location, just click Save. Then we'll move on to the Halo sticker. For this, we need to scroll down to the textures starting with Personal Sticker. Pick one you don't mind losing from the game, and then we'll import our halosticker.dds file as usual. Finally, we need to replace the livery textures. So let's scroll back up and find the textures beginning with Livery Default 1. Other tutorials will suggest replacing different liveries. However, I found that by replacing the default livery, you can have a detailed livery with multiple colours while maintaining the ability to add in-game sponsors during your My Team career. To get our livery into the game, we're going to need to replace two textures. Livery Default 1D we will replace with our livery design. Livery Default 1S we will replace with the material shader. Again, we're going to need to go through the same import process that we have for the rest of the textures. Now that we've imported all the textures we need into the package file, we can save the ERP archive back where we found it, replacing the original file. With all our textures now added into the package files, we're ready to open up F122 and see how it all looks in the game. First, let's go on and create our badge. If we go over to the Emblem tab, we can see our new image. The colours are a little messed up, but we can easily fix this by modifying the values in-game. We need to set our first colour to the reddest red, with values of 0, 240 and 120. And the second to the greenest green, with values of 80, 240 and 120. If you want, you can go back to the Background tab and add an additional background to your image. Once done, we can just head back to the menu. Before we start customizing the livery, we first need to set our driver number to the one we edited in the package file. To do that, we'll head into the player profile and change driver number. Now we can head over to the player car liveries and start creating our car. You can probably already notice that our custom driver number is already displayed on the car. For the livery, we want to select the default livery. This may already be selected for you. If not, you should be able to find it at the far right of the list. Next, we'll add our halo sticker. The design may not appear in the thumbnails. In that case, look for the image you replaced in the previous chapter. You can even take this opportunity to preview what your livery will look like when you add the in-game sponsors to it. And there you have it. Now our car is ready to be taken into our My Team career. Well, I do hope you found that tutorial useful. If you did, please do consider liking and subscribing. It will help others to find this tutorial. And do tune in again soon for more F122 related videos. All that remains for me to say is thank you very much for watching and have a lovely day. Excuse me, I'm trying to record a video here. Bye.